maybe the best leadoff man in history, a good starter, usually gives the U.S. a lead right off the gun. The second lead is Bernard Williams. His experience running the second leg, he has run on that position on Florida's winning team. At this, Brian Lewis. Lewis, still coached by Norfolk State, Steve Riddick, anchored the winning U.S. team at the 76 Olympics, did Riddick in Montreal. And, of course, the anchor is Maurice Greene. He already has taken the gold in the 100, and once more here on the anchor leg of the 4x100. Jamaica getting into the blocks with Frater, John Drummond of the U.S. By the way, the Cuban team had a semifinal win. They could be a threat, too. And they're underway in the 4x100 with John Drummond of the United States. And Drummond is out quickly already, making up the stagger on Jamaica. Second leg coming up with Bernard Williams getting the baton from Drummond. He's steaming down the back stretch. He's already ahead of Jamaica. Brian Lewis will run the third leg for the United States. Here's the baton pass. And Lewis has it. Lewis into the curve. And he's running quickly to find Maurice Greene. Greene to run the anchor. Here's the baton pass. Maurice Greene reaches, takes it, and sets off. Brazil into second, Cuba third, but they won't catch the world's fastest man. U.S. wins 37-6-1. Well, once Maurice Greene got the baton, forget about it.
It was all over. Maurice Greene has so much confidence in what he likes to call his top-end speed, and you got to believe that he was fatigued after running the 100 meters, but he didn't have to run the 200 here, so he had time to rest and get ready for this relay.